Okay. Oh. We go to the bottom of the first.
Leading up.
Here's the former MVP, Jose Altuve.
The second baseman. Okay.
The wind and the pitch.
Altuve.
Ah, that hit him. And the leadoff man is aboard to start the inning.
I think he's getting hit whether he tries to get out of the way or not. That just seemed to be tracking him out of the pitcher's hand.
Alex Bregman in the box now. No balls and a strike. Next offering is foul back. Righty delivers. Ground ball left side, could be two. Flips it behind his back. And they get Bregman for the out. Here's Yordan Alvarez. He's a guy who does it all. With the lack of contact in today's game, this guy hits for contact, so he delivers average. But there's on base and slugging too.
Early in the count, you have to be real careful because of that power. But then if this hitter gets a strike or two on him, he's still very comfortable. And because he has the ability to get the barrel to the baseball, he's a threat deep into the count as well.
Two outs. Got him. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. We played an inning. No score. Bottom of the inning. So here's the Astros cleanup hitter, Jose Abreu. Bieber back to work. Swing and a foul straight back.
Pretty good pitch there to take a rip at. He wants to get his arms extended. He likes the ball away from him a little bit. Just not able to square it up.
Ball, one strike.
And a pitch. It's softly on the ground left side. That takes care of Abreu.
Batting fifth. The right fielder, Kyle.
Here's Kyle Tucker. Swing and a foul over the screen and back out of play. Left-hand batter waits.
Nope. One and one.
High fly ball lifted in the air right field. Kwan makes the grab and there's two gone. And stepping in is the speedy Jeremy Peña. Pretty unique upbringing for Jeremy Peña, at least in terms of a kid who was born in the Dominican Republic, but then he moved to Rhode Island, not exactly a baseball hotbed, and he played his college ball at Maine. He was a University of Maine Black Bear and then went on to be a third round pick of the Astros in 2018. And the 0-2. That one missing inside.
This lineup's going to have to find a way to make him work a little harder out there on the mound. I mean, he is just mowing them down. He's settling in. You got to make him uncomfortable. Maybe step out of the box, call timeout, do whatever it takes.
Two down, nobody on. Gets a piece and stays alive. Swings and misses. Snap throw. 1-2-3 go the Astros. They trail here 1-0. Well, and welcome back. Here's the center fielder, Chaz McCormick. Bieber back to work. That one's in there, and it's 0-1. swings through it for the K. Had him out front for strike three.
Wow, short work to send him packing to start the inning, and no messing around either. All three pitches were in the strike zone, attack mode all the way, and that's pretty impressive given the pop he was dealing with at the plate.
Next to hit, Corey Jolks. Line drive and puts the squeeze on it. That's out number two.
Batting ninth, the catcher,
Martin Maldonado up to hit. Maldonado, a former Gold Glove winner, hitting ninth in today's lineup. And he was born in Puerto Rico. That misses, and it's a ball and a strike.
Puerto Rico doesn't just produce baseball talent. It produces Hall of Fame talent from Roberto Clemente to Pudge Rodriguez.
Strike two. Righty to the plate. Fights that one away. Still one and two. The pitch. Got him swinging for the strikeout. Snuck the fastball by him. Astros are down quietly. They still trail 1-0. Back here in Houston, Jose Altuve up to hit here.
The second baseman, Jose.
And the right-hander back to work. One of the skill sets Altuve brings to the table, he is a notorious bad ball hitter. But whether it's in the zone or out of the zone, since he debuted in 2011, no player has more hits in the majors than Jose Altuve. They say he won.
Yeah, Boog, and Altuve, a three-time AL batting champ and the first second baseman to win multiple batting titles since Hall of Fame second baseman Rod Carew won five batting titles between 1969 and 1975.
1-2 now. Altuve waits. Now this is in the air down the line. Fry on his way over. Tracks it down for the out. One up, one down.
Third baseman, number two.
And now it's Alex Bregman. 0-1 so far.
Bregman.
Bounce to the right side. He steps on the bag. And that quickly, two away.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air. Lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
Now it's Yordan Alvarez. Went down on strikes his first time through. That misses the zone, and that's ball one. And there's a strike. The Astros yet to pick up a hit here. Just missed. That one fouled off, 2-2. And here it comes. Battling here as he fouls it away. Next offering misses, and now it's 3-2. Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. And that'll do it. Nothing doing there for Houston. Still behind by a count of 1-0. Back here in Houston, we head to the bottom of the fifth. Jose Abreu up to hit. Pitch. And first offering is fouled off.
He's been pitching well, but going through this middle of the order second time through, we'll see what kind of adjustments are being made.
Swing and a miss. That's strike two. All one there. The next offering misses. 2-2. Stays alive. Oh, ground ball right side. The flip to the pitcher covering. And the leadoff man set down in their half of the fifth.
Now batting, right fielder, Kyle.
And now the right fielder, Kyle Tucker. Flied out his first time. Next offering, pop foul off to the right out of play. And downstairs. The Stros still looking for their first hit in this one. They say it went.
Two strikes.
The 1-1 is fouled off. Swings through it, and that's a strikeout.
The batter.
So digging in, Jeremy Pena. We talk about guys with good speed, and definitely he has it. But pushing the offense aside for just a second, Chris, it's the defensive side that I think the speed factors in the most. Clips the corner. That is strike two.
Well, he gets to balls that get by most people at that position. Just really impressive because there's certain times the ball comes off the bat, automatically that team that hit it thinks that they've got a base hit or they may have extra bases, and he just takes it away.
The 1-2.
And what makes him even quicker is the fact that he's so dialed in on the pitch as it's moving through the hitting zone. He can see how that hitter's lined up, what he's trying to do, and where that pitch is going to end up, which gives him that real.
And there's the third out. That'll do it for the inning. Astros go down 1-2-3. They're down 1-0. Welcome. Back here at Minute Maid Park, John Ciampi with Chris Singleton in the booth, and leading off the bottom of the sixth, Chaz McCormick.
When a guy's throwing a lot of first pitch strikes as a hitter, you got to be ready to hit. Now, that's not going to help you get deep into his pitch count and into the bullpen, but you got to take what he's offering that day.
Swing and a miss, struck him out. Slider got him for strike three.
Oh, there's a three-pitch strikeout. He can do whatever he wants with the baseball right now.
Corey Jolts now at the plate. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Jolts, in his rookie season, 27 years old, and he was drafted in the eighth round back in 2017. Grounder off the pitcher. Two up, two down. Definitely some concern here. That ball came back and got him right on the pitching arm, as you can see him trying to shake it off.
And if nothing else, you worry about him getting some dead arm and losing some feeling. But from what I can tell, I think they're going to let him continue, and that's a really good sign.
Swing and a miss. That's strike one.
And it really looks like these hitters have been in between with their timing today. Good fastball, excellent slider, but they've not been able to commit to one velocity and stay there.
Next one just misses. 2-2.
I always remember watching Johan Santana pitch, and when he was in his prime.
And a swing and a miss. Snap throw. Astros are down quietly, and it remains 1-0. We go to the top of the. And welcome back. And now, Jose Altuve. The right-hander back to work. That's a strike. Next offering is in for a strike.
That curveball's been a big pitch for him today. He's been able to get ahead in the count with it. He's also been able to use it to put guys away.
Kwan settles underneath it. Squeezes it. And a quick out number one. Now it's Alex Bregman.
Number two. Alex Bregman.
That one's in there 0-1. Oh. popped up. Ramirez settles under it. Puts it away for the out. Here's the left fielder, Yordan Alvarez. That's in for a strike.
Well, I'm impressed with that challenge pitch right there. Even with this slim lead, this guy's not afraid to go right after these hitters.
The Astros hitless so far in the game. Next pitch is outside. Swing and a miss, and he is down on strikes for the third straight at bat. Righty reliever out of the pen. So here's the cleanup hitter, Jose Abreu. And this lineup is still hitless as we begin the eighth. In the air, left side. Kwan settles underneath it. And there's one down.
Still rolling to start the eighth. Just five more outs to get.
Now it's the right fielder, Kyle Tucker. That one called a strike. It's 0-1. Now a slow roller to second. Jimenez tosses to first, and a couple of quick outs. So just four more outs to get through, and the tension is building in the ballpark right now.
Yeah, and we can feel it in the booth. He's got these hitters locked up.
Payne in the box again, takes a strike. Next offering is in for a strike.
Trying to keep good speed off the bases. Flew open a little bit with that front shoulder, but was able to slow his back down just enough to make contact with that pitch. Keep the at-bat alive.
Fights it off. He'll see another. The pitch. That's foul off to the right side. Keeps the AB going.
Pitcher having a pretty tough time getting that swing and miss. Third foul ball in a row.
Next pitch misses inside. Now 1-2. This one popped up. Foul ground, first base side. Makes the catch, and that will end the inning. Hector Neris will take over here. Well, one-run game. Chaz McCormick digs in now. There's a strike.
Can only imagine the nerves that some of the defensive players have right now. You got to have the mindset, I want the ball hit to me, but in front of that, you hope that he strikes the hitter out.
Three outs from a no-hitter. In the dirt. Toss to Naylor, and they get the leadoff man in the ninth.
That's a pretty nasty pitch right there. I'd call it a power curveball in the 80s. It's got so much spin on it, and you really don't have a lot of time to sit back and watch what it's going to do before you have to commit. It was a good one for the swing and strikeout.
That one catches the zone, and 1-1.
One way to make a guy real uncomfortable at the plate is pound him inside with good velocity. They're doing that right here.
Kicks and deals. That one down the line, and it goes just foul. Crowd locked in right now. One run game here in the ninth. Pitch misses, and the count's full. Next pitch is popped up. Naylor pulls it down, and he makes the catch. Two down. And now the toughest one is left to get. The final out to complete the no-hitter.
Yeah, and not much we can say anymore. Everyone knows what this situation is, and he's so close, Boone, he can taste it.
He puts it away. It's a no-hitter.
Congratulations to him. He was dominant all game long. Got some really nice play behind him defensively. It seemed like everyone was on board, pulling for him to finish the no-hitter, but most importantly, get the W for the team.